Eric Clapton is probably one of the best-known guitar players out there. His career dates all the way back to the early 1960s with the group The Yardbirds, and from there he moved on to John Mayall's Bluesbreakers, and then there's also his work with the band Cream and his solo work. You know, with all that music under his belt and with such a huge catalog of recordings, touring, and overall working in the business, it's no wonder that he's become so well-known, and not just to guitar players, because I think you'd be pretty hard-pressed to find very many people who haven't heard of Eric Clapton. Now, in this video, we're going to discuss his playing style, the scales he enjoys, and we'll look at a few of his blues licks to better understand how he formulates his approach to playing lead. So let's get started on this episode of the Guitar Blog Insider by covering Eric Clapton's guitar style. Well, let's get started by just discussing some of the background of Eric Clapton, some of the gear he uses, stuff like that. As you probably well know, he has a fairly diverse playing style. He's very competent on both electric and acoustic guitar, and he can play by way of both flat picking and finger style. He can do them both with ease. When it comes to his guitars, he started out actually on Gibson Les Pauls, and then he switched over to Fender Stratocasters in the year 1970, with his legendary Blackie probably being the most publicly well-known Eric Clapton Stratocaster. I should also mention that he has a custom-made Martin guitar that he uses as well. Now, his playing style isn't based really upon shredding up the neck, like maybe some of the other legendary playing styles of Stevie Ray Vaughan, for instance, or modern blues shredders like Joe Bonamassa. But even though Clapton is a fast player when he wants to be, he also has a way of really drawing on a lot of soulfulness and slow energy through his guitar parts. And when it comes to his sound, it's pretty generic. He generally just uses a fairly clean tone with a little bit of natural tube overdrive here and there. And through the last decade, he's been pretty much sticking with the Fender Twin Custom Shop Amplifier. So with that out of the way, let's jump into the scales and the approach that Clapton takes with his scale selections. When it comes to scales, Eric Clapton has a great level of control over both major and minor sounds. In fact, he's very well known for mixing the scales of both major and minor pentatonic, and I've got a really cool Clapton style lick that blends these two scale colors together, all within one phrase. So let's check it out. It goes like this. It's in B. One more time, a little slower. Now what happens with that is we start out as major pentatonic, taking it from the root of the chord into the major third, walking up the upper tones of the major pentatonic, and then we slip into the minor pentatonic, then into blues scale on the third string, and then we're going to go back to some major sounds, and end on the flatted seventh tone of that B dominant seventh chord. It's an A. Now, to create ideas like this of your own, all you really need to do is work on formulating ideas that will drift between the minor pentatonic and blues scale into the major pentatonic. So as long as you know your blues scale fairly well, and then your major pentatonic off the same root, as you know those scales well, you can start developing ideas that drift between the two, just like you had seen in the lick that we played. So these are really a lot of fun to mess around with, and after you do it for a while, you're going to come up with some very cool Eric Clapton sounding licks. When Clapton isn't blending together the major and minor pentatonic scales, he sticks quite close to home with a lot of his sound taken from the notes of the minor pentatonic. However, as you play a lot more of his leads, you're going to start to notice something. He likes the sound of adding the major second interval around the tones of the minor pentatonic. It creates a pretty smooth sounding scale tone effect, and when you add it in, it gets you sounding like Eric Clapton rather quickly. So here's an example of him doing this exact idea in a short selection of his lead from the song Lay Down Sally. One, two, three. All right, let's break this thing down. It comes in on the upbeat of three. So as you count in, you're going one, two, three. You can see we walk up there from the A take it into the C tone and then into the D tone there. And then we're going into the fifth fret here for the C again, but we're gonna do it as eighth notes. The first one's gonna be bent slightly with a half step bend. So you hear that bend comes in on the first attack there. And then you play in the fifth fret normally again. There's a quarter rest, and then into the next measure, there's an eighth rest, and that's when we walk into that second degree. Now this is based around the sounds of A, so the second degree off of A is obviously a B tone, and we're gonna roll into it from C to B, and then we're gonna drop down into fourth string, have the A, the G, down into the fifth string, seventh fret E, back to that G again, slide from the fifth string, seventh fret E to D, go into the C down lower here on the fifth string, third fret, come back to the D tone, and on that D tone, we're gonna just play quickly, short and detached, kind of staccato idea. Come back to the C, we're gonna bend that note, and then play it normally again. So very similar to what we had done up here. And then we're gonna wrap things up from the A to the G, and then into the A. So here it is, nice and slow for you. One, two, three. So you can tell it's a pretty cool idea. It's a really nice sound to add in that second degree tone around the notes of the minor pentatonic. It's just adding a B tone in the key of A. You can take it around any minor pentatonic, you know, slip in that second degree and you get a really cool Eric Clapton style and effect. You know, phrasing is a huge part of exploring the Clapton style and his application of using multiple ideas like vibrato, position slides, bends, legato, you know, hammer-on pull-offs, all that stuff, all combined, even into the shortest of guitar licks, is pretty well known with his style. Now, this side of his playing is a really huge factor in generating that Eric Clapton guitar sound. And to give you an idea of exactly what I'm talking about, I've taken a short segment from his solo of the song After Midnight to help you get a better understanding of how he works at combining a number of phrasing concepts into one short lead statement. So check this out. One, two, three, four. All right, let's break that down nice and easy. He starts off here looking at things in terms of the key of C. And that riff is like. So we're all kind of like C, rocking out in the key of C. We're moving forward in the beginning of that lick from 11 to 13 on the second string. And then we're gonna come back here off the first string and we're gonna have this movement of E flat over to the C there. A little bit of a sustain on it, but not much. And then we're gonna go to the third string, drop G down to F as a slide idea, and then heading to E flat, you know, and that's gonna be basically the first part of the phrase. That's taking us to that C tone there. And then what happens at that point is we're going to be doing a pull-off from 10 to the 8th fret, and then we're going to go over across to this E flat, 8th fret, taking us back again to that 10th fret, 4th string. Because again, that's a C, and we're really outlining the sounds of C there. A little bit slower. So you gotta remember a couple things on this run. There's lots of sliding ideas happening. We're sliding action here from that 11th to 13th, coming down the scale, sliding back here, 12 to 10 on the third string, slight bend on that 8th fret third string, pull off idea when we go to the fourth guitar string, and then we're coming back around here to this 8th fret, then to the root of the chord, the C, and we're sort of drifting that down with another sort of slide to nowhere. So there's lots of action happening in this lick. So, you know, take that to heart, practice those ideas, and try to really, you know, take all your lines, and you're trying to sound like Eric Clapton, take your lines and begin implementing a lot of these same phrasing tools. You know, look at all the vibrato he's using, all the position slides that he has, lots of bending, lots of legato work with hammer-ons, pull-offs, and if you can start implementing those sounds around the minor pentatonic, you can slowly but surely start to sound like Eric Clapton. Well, the final idea I want to go over with you is Clapton's approach to playing within the classic blues feel. It's one of his specialties, and it's an area that if you enjoy Clapton's guitar playing, you'll definitely want to spend some time exploring this side of his guitar personality. You know, in this realm of his playing, you know, one of the best albums to spend time listening to and working out songs from is his 1994 blues cover album, From the Cradle. This is not just an amazing album, but it's a chance to take in the full scope of his trademark blues guitar phrasing and his approach to playing blues licks, you know. So to help you best understand this, I want to have a look at a cover that he did of Sonny Thompson's song. It's called I'm Tore Down. It was originally made popular by Freddie King, but Clapton's cover is a great example of his skill for blues phrasing. So check out Clapton's intro lick from the song I'm Tore Down. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's break this lick down a little bit here. It's in the key of C, and what it starts out off of from is on the like a pickup note idea from the fourth beat. It's an eighth note triplet. We miss the downbeat of four. We have this two note chord coming in. It's on ninth and tenth frets of the third and second strings. It's the major third of the C dominant blues chord, but it's also adding in this sixth note. It's an A, so it's like a 13th added in there. Heads us right over there to that C tone, and what happens next is we're going to be doing a bend on the 10th fret of the first string, and then we're going to move forward and we're going to do a full step bend on 11, and then down for a half step, and then back to that C. Sounds real B.B. King-ish, doesn't it? So we got this really cool sound of those bends up top there. And then what's going to happen next is we're going to do a hammer-on on second string into that B flat on the 11th fret of the second string there, and then back to that A. And then what we're going to do after that and is take it over to the 10th fret on third string, back to the 8th fret second string, back to 10th fret third string, have a slight bend on the 8th fret of third, and then wrap things up with a run going on 4th string, 10th fret, 8th fret, and then into the 5th interval, 10th fret G on the 5th string there. So let's go through that nice and easy so you really understand the full scope of things here. Take notice of those bends especially, because they're so important in the sound of this. And also, you know, take some time to make sure you get that nice clean sound on the hammer-on on second string. And then we have that half step bend right there. Eighth fret, third string. Wrapping things up into that perfect fifth interval down low on the fifth string, 10th fret on that G. One more time, a little faster. 1, 2, 3, 4. So as you can tell, some really nice sounds on that lick, some interesting bending, really cool bluesy, classic bluesy sounds from Eric Clapton on that one. Eric Clapton's phrasing and his technique have, without any doubt, established him and his guitar playing as one of the greatest guitar players around. And once you can start learning how to organize the Clapton style of both phrasing concepts and his approach to using scales and technique, you'll be able to apply his guitar playing concepts into your own music, into your own guitar playing style. He's a fantastic player and one that can tap into a very smooth and soulful guitar sound. So it's definitely worth learning. I hope these ideas presented here in this lesson help you get started down the path to developing the Eric Clapton guitar style. Well, thanks for joining me. If you want to learn more about what I do as an online guitar teacher, then head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for your free lifetime membership. When you want more, you can always upgrade to either a basic or premium lesson package on the site and start studying all the guitar courses I've organized for the members of the website. Also, I'd be interested to hear your thoughts on all this in the comments section below. If you like Eric Clapton, if you've got any interesting Eric Clapton stories, some things that you've learned along the way if you've been developing his style, just pop them in the comments section there and share your thoughts and your ideas. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Thanks again, and we'll catch up next week for another episode of the Guitar Blog Insider.
When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com.
I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.